family, it's Tasha, Mama Bear Prepping. Welcome to the channel. Welcome back to the channel. Happy Tuesday. I hope everybody had a beautiful, long, relaxing weekend, especially my fellow veterans. I hope that you guys were chill, relaxed, maybe got some free stuff yesterday. Who knows? And of course, prayers and blessings to all my brothers and sisters serving overseas, forward deployed, not able to be home with their families right now. So let's talk about some things. You know, I want to talk about this topic that, you know, I'm starting to see pop up. This all started about a week and a half ago. You know, I had a feed, I'm sure you guys have seen it, news feed popped up, you know, hey, China's going through a bout of COVID, no big deal, right? Really nothing to see here at all. And how, you know, they had been basically dealing with a surge since December-ish, right? And it's this last variant, same variant that's going around here, right? And how they were discussing that the way forward, that the way that things are moving there, that they anticipate 65 million people infected every single week. Now, right off the top, that's just like, whoa, that's really, really big numbers. I mean, that supersedes anything we've ever seen here. And but you have to remember, they have billions of people there, and they're highly, millions and millions concentrated in these cities, right? And we have the same thing, right? But these are like monster cities that they have, and there's a lot of people crammed into them. And so 65 million, also, when you talk about they lock their people down, like extreme lockdown, like the movies, like, whoa, this isn't real, right? Everything short from just firing, right? You know, firing lines, right? They locked people down. And when you lock people down, what that did was obviously that whole piece of society, that whole group of people, couldn't build up natural immunity, right? And of course, yes, more people would have died. Of course, you guys, I don't know if you know this, but that's what happens when a disease and a virus comes through. People do die, okay? And that's not to be so harsh about it and so, you know, turned off and negative about it, but that is the truth, right? People die, natural selection, and especially if you have other ailments, it just increases it. And when you have a people that got locked down, that government locked their people down, therefore they weren't able to be out and about in the world, be able to make their own decisions in life, right? With their interactions with people, whatever. And although that, you know, maybe saved some consequences of death, what it did was nobody built up immunity. And so now they've lifted that, and now you have, you know, millions and millions and millions of people walking around that didn't build anything up, nothing to fight. And now one of the deadliest strands is around. And of course they have all these infections, and it's been happening. My only real concern about this is that we're never going to get the true story, the real story. First of all, we've talked many, many times on this channel about how you cannot fully trust the news. You can't trust what is being put out to us. What is being put out to us is exactly what they want us to know. I'll give you an example. I'm talking about this article. I saw this article probably the first time on my feed, maybe a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago. And literally yesterday, I'm sitting down relaxing with my family, and it keeps popping up. Different news feeds that I follow, it starts popping up. The same thing I keep seeing pop up on my phone in different news articles. 65 million infections a week happening in China, yada, yada, yada. And I'm like, this is really, really being pushed down our throats. And this isn't international news notifications I'm getting. Like, this is everyday news channels and platforms that I watch to just see what's happening, you know, what's the norm about what is being put out. And this, and so of course it's a big eye roll. It's a big, you know, okay, right? Who cares? You know, everybody is numb to what happened. There's things that were positive to be learned, that we learned as a people because of what we went through the last few years. But there's also very, very nasty, very ugly, evil things that happened as well. And those evil people learned kind of what worked and what they could do. And even fraudsters and basic people, how to make money and the things that people would be desperate for, and just all this bad stuff was learned as well. And it's time though, because you can't be complacent. You can't just have your eyes closed and be like, okay, I'm done with it. I'm over it. I don't want to talk about it anymore. I don't want to do it. They officially said it's over. I'm done with it. But we also know, and we also talk about on this channel, that more is to come. And that could be different levels or variations or crazy stuff with this being worse. There was articles the other day of people discussing that this has been manufactured into something more dangerous, more potent, you know, in our own states, playing around with COVID and mixing it up and making stronger strains of it and, you know, doing science-y type stuff, right? And that's dangerous. That's, to me, that's playing with fire. And there's only a matter of time before something bigger is happening. So you have to keep your head on a swivel. You still have to pay attention. I'm not saying when stuff like this happens, these articles come out, that you just, you know, freak out. And I'm not saying just roll your eyes and not pay attention to it. Just pay attention to it. Take a minute, read through things, see what is being put out. And then you're going to make decisions. And you need to be thinking about your family now for this next round, whatever it is that happens. I can promise you this, it's going to be worse. It's either going to be a worse strand of what we just went through, or it's going to be something completely different. And I promise you 100% it's going to be worse. Worse in the sense of higher death rates, more people dying, more people getting sick, which means a higher level of chaos, a higher level of crime, a higher level of everything that we just went through, a higher level of all the politics with our children and school and everything, right? And so how do you prepare for that? You prepare now on the school situation. You prepare now for the home situation and staying home. You prepare for your medicines, your stockpile of your medicines, your over-the-counter medicines, your vitamins. I cannot stress the vitamins, okay? Vitamins almost more than over-the-counter medicines, okay? So vitamins, stuff to build up your immunity now, right now, today. Not stuff you stockpile for later. Yes, you want to have stuff stockpile for later. You know, maybe you don't take, for example, NAC today, but maybe if you started getting sick, whatever, you start introducing NAC into your system, your everyday vitamin regimen, whatever you're going to do. You need your vitamins. You need your holistic stuff. You need your over-the-counter stuff. You need all the medical type stuff, your blood pressure cuff check, your oximeter, your different things, your breathing treatment stuff. All of the different things that were helpful then, make sure that you have that stuff now. Make sure you take the time to get your little recipes and stuff together now, written down now. Make sure you're stockpiling your cleaning stuff. All the extra stuff that you wanted to have then that was maybe hard for you to find, get that stuff. Make sure that you're stockpiled on that. Keep a clean house, right? Watch your surroundings when you're out and about and not being all on top of people. I'm not saying don't live your life, don't go out and do stuff. I'm not saying it's time to walk down in your house and not stop going to parties and stop hanging out with family functions. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying be smart about some stuff, right? Be smart about your movements. Be smart about your distances. Be smart about how strong you're making your body, your family and your body, as far as your immune system, right? Now's the time, okay? We learned that what could happen, but what's bad is that people are complacent, getting complacent, and something worse could happen. Now, do I think because people learned that they could just, it's like riding a bike now, they could just get back in line, like, okay, here we go. Yes, but you're gonna have people who are not ready and who are like, forget it, I don't care. Because COVID was not that extreme. Really it wasn't. When it comes to death, it really was nothing, you guys. Nothing compared to what this world has seen in decades past and centuries past, right? And so it's scary to think how bad it could ever get, and people's reaction and the chaos that ensues after that, the violence that ensues after that, the desperation, the starvation, the people not having things, right? Of course, you're still stockpiling the things, water, food, meds, but really, really take a look and think about children, think about pets, medicines and vitamins and things that make them feel better when they are sick. All your cold medicines, you know, in these articles, they kept alluding like, oh, they've had a run on the stores when it comes to the cold medicine. Since December, you can't get cold medicine in China, yada, yada, yada. You know, get that stuff now. Don't be the one trying to fight and something happens and you're trying to fight going to the store to get stuff that you need, right? That's the point of preparedness. That's the point of stockpiling. That's the point of being self-sufficient, right? If you have this stuff built up into your home pharmacy, your home hospital, you are ready for various things that could happen medically, not only a pandemic, okay? And so very, very important. Like something as simple as gloves. People were freaking out they couldn't get gloves during gloves are needed in your home pharmacy, home hospital, regardless, for anything, right? You need to have gloves to be able to put on your hands when you're assisting somebody who's ill, you're changing a cut, you're doing whatever it is. Gloves is extremely, extremely important. So get your gloves, get the things that the sizes you need and the stuff you know that is good and people are not allergic to. Just really, really, really important to take a look at that stuff. Think about back when you were freaking out, there was something you needed, and get stockpiled on those things. And start fighting and getting your body in a way and at a point where it's able to fight what is going to come its way, so that's you're building natural immunity, right? And your body's getting stronger and stronger, so that when the stronger stuff comes, you're able to fight it. Now, something really nasty can come that there is no on building immunity, Ebola, something crazy. Well, it still matters how strong you are at the point that you get anything, any kind of disease, any kind of virus is dependent. First line, what is the starting point of your body when that's introduced is huge, okay? And so just so many things to be learned. That's all I took from this article was, okay, take it with a grain of salt, because again, they only tell us what they want to tell us. And two, my concern is if things did start to get nasty, China has never been one to really share information, share true numbers of deaths, of illnesses, of really truly what is happening. And so if it really did start to pop off, I'm not sure that we would really know, especially when you throw these exact same language, you know, news articles across the board. They all got the same story. And they spread it out to us. And so then the people that are paying attention, you know, they see that, maybe they want to keep up on things, and they see that and they're like, oh, this is ridiculous. Like, we don't care. And then when it does start to pop off, there's no concern. Nobody's really paying attention, because it's not that you cried wolf, but there was no emphasis on like truly what the concern is. It's just these false articles to give us whatever information to make us evoke a certain emotion. You know, is this to cause panic? Is it to mentally get us ready because they know we're shutting off? Is it to get people ready and get it back in their foreminds that this is dangerous? Oh no, a new wave is coming. I think that it's gonna take a little bit more than, oh no, a new wave is coming, for people to really get going. And that's the dangerous part as well, because if something dangerous does come along, there is a lot of complacency, and there is a lot of people that are like, oh no, another wave, who cares, right? And so I think it's very important, especially having these channels, us having these channels, not saying one way or the other that like, oh no, the sky's falling, but also don't just sleep with your eyes closed. It's like everything else that we do and that we prepare for, is just making sure that you're ready either way, and not losing sleep over it, and not freaking out, and not losing your head and your cool over something that it's just not worth that energy that it's bringing into your space. Okay. So anyway, I hope again, you guys had a great weekend. I hope you guys have a fabulous week, or it's a short week, so it should be a good week for anybody that's working. And I'll see you guys tomorrow on the next video. Take care. Bye.